We're gonna go into a reference drill. Now, before I start, I gotta tell you, some of the techniques that I teach in it, you've seen already. There's a lot of crossover techniques in this art, but what the emphasis is on this is gonna be way different than what you've seen before. Now, the whole drill that I'm gonna show you, I've kinda touched on this already. A lot of times when we do trapping, we judge this as if, actually you pox off. When he goes pock down, he hits, you're gonna get different style blockers. Some people won't block. They'll get hit. Obviously, that's what you hope for, and that's what we're trying to prevent you from being that guy who doesn't block. All right, so when he goes, there's the guy that passes center line. So he will lops out, and he could hit. All right, don't even worry about the blocks. I'm just mainly worried on the reference point. Then there's the other guys, when they block, they just kind of pot or parry it. I've already talked about this. All right, then you're going to get other guys who are real strong and lock out. You're going to get guys that run from you. You're going to get guys that attack back. This drill will help you through that, through all of that. So let's take this piece by piece. First one, since we did it already, when he slaps and punches or pox house, all right, I am gonna block past the center line. He will come up with a BUG and he will lop sao da. Okay, so let's do that a few times, go. Do you see it? See it real slow. See how I slap it past and then he comes right through that hole from underneath and then he's gonna pull and punch. Do it slowly. See how this bottom hand that's trapping my arm comes up underneath and grabs my hand and then lops out eyes. You guys should have this. You're an intermediate student. This should be pretty medial to you now. So now, one more time. Do it at speed once. That's it. One more time. There. Okay? Now, the next one, you're going to get the guy who's strong. When you slap, he locks out. Okay? So that means, actually do it one more time. If I were to be a little lighter, he wants to get through and hit, obviously, right? So if he goes in with the next one and I lock out, he's gonna pull, he's gonna run up that arm and punch me in the face. What I mean, he's gonna just run right up this arm. So one more time, I lock out, he pulls and punches. This is also lop sao, okay? What we say is this is second barrier because he goes for the second hand. First barrier is where he attacks the first hand, okay? All right, so let me swing it this way. Let me look at it this way. All right, so first one was pox out. I push past center line, pull, punch. Second one, pox out, I lock it out. He pulls and punches. So just play with your opponent, or your partner, not your opponent, and just go. So I just sit there and I just kind of go, okay, John, you're on. Just play with it, there. See, he's just got to feel it out. And you're always going to anticipate. I find myself still anticipating, and it puts you in the wrong sector. The idea of this whole drill is to minimize that anticipation to want to go to a certain sector. So at the start, I ask you to just go slow with it. It's tempting to go fast and blitz it, but then you'll see there's a bunch of mistakes. You slow down, there's less mistakes. After a while, you're going faster with less mistakes. That's the whole idea. So when he goes, I just go. I don't tell him what I'm going to do. I might act like I'm going to be strong, and then I just block it, and I give into it. Sometimes I'll act like I'm going to be light, and then I lock out. You don't know, or he doesn't know. Sometimes I don't know until it happens. All right, but the idea is now he's starting to learn the paths on where to go. So now I put the third one in, and this really trips up people. So we go one, and I stop it. Now, loy pox sao da. I know you've been taught this already, but you're going to trap. See, it's trapping. Remember, we're trapping, hence the word trapping. You got to trap the arm. Do loy pox sao da wrong way. If you go like that, see, this isn't going to be too good. He's going to get hit. So what we do is we go one, slides in, get the trap. Do it again. One, slide in, trap. Do you see that? Again, there, that's it. Okay, so now let's add that to the mess. See, he anticipated. I knew I can get him to do it. Go. There you go. Go. There. So just take your time. Don't go fast at the start. Sometimes sometimes being the feeder, it almost takes, it's gonna sound crazy, but a little more talent than the person doing it, because I could trip them up and give them the wrong energy, and sometimes I want to, but sometimes if you get a person who's not used to feeding this, he'll just overdo it too much, and you're gonna be fighting different elements besides the feeling you're supposed to be working. So if we go here, go one, good, one, good, one, good. See it? So now he's learning different paths. There you go, go. Good, go, there. Now one way you could tell your student, a lot of times, now we always tell everybody block here. usually when you're gonna do the pock sal, not block, or pock sal. So if I'm gonna go here, I pock, which is different if he slaps and comes at me. If I'm more of like a boxing style blocker at this range, I don't do this, okay? A hard stylist will tend to push past. More of a soft stylist will block more at the elbow and light. That should tell him to slap it off and then hit on the inside. So now if you look at it, when he's doing this drill, I'm not giving him mixed messages. If he feels this, he knows, go across. If he's feeling this, he knows, stay on the inside. You see it? I'm not pushing his hand past our center line or the line that connects us. All right, or let's say past his nose. All right, if he goes one, I go right there. You see it? Okay, so we have three elements now. Do the first one, one. Second one, third one. Good. All right, now let's go into the fourth element. The fourth element is I'm gonna punch him back. So when he goes one, he's gonna go right here. This is called tanda, okay? So then he's gonna go pak sal. This is called wan jern. He also has a choice of going chung choi or any other fist as long as he's safe and he doesn't kill you, okay? And then he'll go tan, sut, and then pak, wan jern, we'll say for now, okay? So we'll just do wan jerns. They're easy and they're safe, meaning you could control them pretty good. Let's spin you on this side so they can see this. So one, so I go right here. See the tan da, pak, wan jern, tan, wan jern, pak, wan jern. Do it again. There, one, two, three. Again, there. So what I'm doing is, before John could land, go real dead slow. Before he could land that punch, he has to convert it to tan sal and then da. Okay, da is the punch, remember that? Okay, so one, tan da. Okay, pak wan jern, tan sut, pak wan jern. Okay, we can also swing back. Do it from the other side. So now my arm jiao sals when he pak sals. All right, one, I loop around, I hit. I'm just leaving his hand down so you could see it. One more time. One, right there. So then he does the same thing on the opposite side. Pak wan jern, tan sut, pak wan jern. So John doesn't know which one I'm gonna go to. So if he goes, one, there, one, two, three. Or here, one, two, three. So now we have five elements, right? I'm going five, I'm good, five, all right? All right, so he goes, pak sal, lop. Pak sal, lop on the same arm. Pak sal, loi pak. Okay, pak sal, tan da. Pak sat pak. Now I'm gonna jiao. There, one, two, three. So now you mix up those five elements. So this is, I don't want you to unload this all on whoever you're working with. If you're teaching students, don't throw everything on them. I mean, for the longest time, I would do two to three elements and leave that. Then after they got really crisp and really good at it, then I would throw a couple more in. So when we go, I'm just gonna mix it up, go. Good, go. There, if you mess up, just correct and keep going. Good. Okay, that's the five. Now, we're gonna go on a little further, okay? Next one, he's gonna pak sal. I am gonna go to run away. He's gonna kick, and then he's gonna punch back. See, the idea is, if I do this to John, if I go one, and if he turns to run away, and if I land that round kick, whoop, usually, if he goes, he's gonna turn back to retaliate and hit. So do it to me one more time. Watch this. One, I turn, he gets a kick, I go, come back. He doesn't let me come back. He pocks the shoulder. The slap goes on the shoulder, and he's gonna hit me anywhere he sees a valid spot to land the blow. That's gonna be our number six in this. So we go, pak sal, I go to run, and then he turns and he hits me, okay? One more time. One, I go to run, and right there. All right, which brings us to number seven, which is like the brother-sister technique of this. Sometimes if he goes, and if I go way out there, he has no choice but to kick. But if I do not go that far away from him, do the kick. It doesn't feel good from there, does it? No. So what I do is I convert the kick into a knee, and then he pocks the shoulder the same way he did. So the idea is this. If I go here, and if it goes far away, go far away, see, I can't land a knee, so I put the kick in, and I pock, and I hit. You see that? See, but if he doesn't run away, I just go, boom, and then I pock, and I hit. So you're just gonna land a knee right in the quad, okay, or in the side of the thigh. All right, so he goes, now we have what, 7 elements. All right, so he goes, 1, kick there, number 2, not number 2, just mixing up, I won't count, there, that's it. Okay, or I just mix it up in the whole mess, all right. Good. Good. That's it. All right, so you got 7 pieces now. All right, now let's go on to number 8. Number 8, if John goes pox out, and then I'm going to body tackle or double leg tackle. So when I do that, he doesn't, let me double leg tackle once. Don't defend. When he goes, I want to come here, okay? I want to get in and I want to scoop him down. So he doesn't want that happen. He doesn't want it to happen, obviously. So this is his reply. When he goes 1, and I go to come in, he locks this elbow down. He steps. If I get this leg, he'll pull away and make me pay for coming in. Okay. All right. So one more time. 1. I go here. So he tears away, and then he's just gonna hit. Okay. One more time. Okay, that's the reply. All right, there are times when I come in and I stop my motion. Then there are going to be other times when the guy keeps pressing forward. So right now, when he goes, 1, when I come in, he's going to scoop and then he's going to kick it down. And then the kick could be right there if he wanted to. We'll leave that out for now. Okay, all right, so let's spin around. Remember the Hun Sao? This is Hun Sao. So when he goes in and I come here, he scoops me, he kicks that knee out, and then that's where that would come. We won't do it when we drill, okay? All right, so again, 1, scoop, blast that knee down, and then you know it's gonna go on from there. Okay, so now when we come here, the sister technique to that, actually I gotta spin you again, all right, is when he comes in and then I slip under it, let me talk for a second, and I get I get too deep for him to get the stop or the scoop. Okay, so if I get in this far, go. He headlocks, coming at me. So if I go 1 and he comes under it, I drop my weight and then I step back. See how I get the face right here? And then I just lift it. Do you see that? Okay, let me change the view so we try it from here. So when I go 1, he slipped in too far, I drop. I just turn, see how I hook it right here? And then I just lift it. So basically, spin around this way now. When I get it, it's like the head turns sideways, it's on my rib, and then I lift it. So the head and the body lift right here. It kind of guillotines him like it's gonna snap his neck off. It's not a choke, all right? So now, with this whole thing, I just play with it. You go 1. That's it. Okay. Go. Good. All right, my turn. So, I just start off slow. Good. Oh, now also, God, what's wrong with me? All right, here, we have one more that I do want you to have, is if he takes the full step back. You see it? That's a little bit different. Come back. So now if I went pox out and he did the shoulder roll away from me, this is where I come with the kick, or if it was close with the knee, right? But there are times your opponent will step back. Do that again. Don't even block, just step back. Boop, right there. So if he does this, what I want you to do is I want you to pendulum step in, and you're going to kick the groin. So one more time. I'm not done yet. It goes 1. I pendulum step, kick the groin, and then you're gonna pop da. You see it? This is the last one I want you to know, I promise. Okay, so when he comes in, I pendulum, kick the groin, and pox out da. So when we put that into the mix, he's just gonna go. We'll just go slow with it. All right, so he's just gonna give me different energies. So if I round kick, in. See, now I pendulum, and then I go in. That's what I want you to have. So again, the last one. One, if he goes, I pendulum, kick the groin, and pock. Okay? You got that? All right, that's what I want you to have for the reference point drill. All right, we're gonna go on now, and I want you to get the Jiao Cao reference points. The last thing I want you to do in the reference point drill is what we call Jiao Cao. So this is really short, it's not bad. I'm gonna do this. When I do the Jiao Cao is the running hand. I wanna swing out and hook. So off of the slap, I hook him, all right? Now, he's gonna have three replies to this. One, no reply. Maybe he fell for the pock. Maybe he thinks, I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna pock, so he's trying to stop me from touching his face or whatever I'm going after. So if I do fool him, I hit. Do you see it? That's our first score. One, hit, okay? That's the Jiao Cao. The second one is he doesn't fall for it and he blocks. So say I go to hit, I'm gonna pull, trap, and hit. One more time, one, pull and hit. Do you see that? Okay, the third one is he blocks it. See how he blocks in? He isn't just covering, he's blocking it. So when we go one, he blocks. I want you to go to the groin. We just slap the thigh for training, but this is slap the groin, slap the chin, and then they hit. All right, so what I do is I go one, two, three, four. You see it one more time? Right there, two, three, four. This could be the up, but we just slap touch, okay? So now John isn't gonna tell me what three he's gonna use. Sometimes he'll fall for it, hands up, fall for it, and I get the hit. Usually I just take the slap or I hit past for now. Just so I don't have to pause or hesitate, I train myself to go whoop like that, and then I go one, two, three. So we go bang, one, two, three. Then if he blocks or just covers, I'm gonna pull and then I'm gonna trap and hit. Do it again, one, two, three. Third one is he blocks it. Slap, touch, hit. One more time. There. There. So now, we'll do it slowly, but you don't tell me which one you're gonna do. Go. One, two, three. See, I kind of hesitated a little bit, but that's okay. If you do, you just work past it. All right, so again, I can get the hit, one, two, three. I can get the stop or the block. Okay, that's the three that I want you to know. It's important if you get the hit to continue on. If he gets the block, pull, or if he pushes it, slap up, one, two, and three. That's the three that you need to know for the reference point for the Jiao Cao. Okay, now we're into advanced focus mitts. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring my wife in, Diana. All right, this is what we call the split series. So what we mean by split is, right now let me take this mitt off. If I punch Diana, and if she parries on one side of the hand, and if she hits me with the other side, this is what we call the split series. So it's a split entry. She's in between my arm, okay? So everything that we do within a series right now is gonna stay with that format. This is how we prefix everything. So when she goes, the first one is she's just gonna hit it. Do you see it? Or not even the first one, everyone. This is how she starts it. As I punch, she parries and she's gonna strike. Right now the mitt represents my face. So we go one, right there. I will step back, she's just gonna come in. One, two, three, and then she adds the kick. All right, let me do that again. You see it? All right, so this is our number one. It's pretty simple, you could get this. Just start off slow, right here. Split, one, two, three, and kick. Okay, do it one more time at speed, please. Again. All right, that's number one. Number two, when she does the number two, this time she retains my arm, meaning she stays connected. See how she stays connected? And then she's gonna come up and over and hit the mitt, and then she's gonna cross, she'll hook, she'll cross, and then kick. Okay, so what I mean by retain it, if I were gonna use terminology, when she comes in, she's gonna lao xing choi. Lao xing choi is actually this hand. So right now, let me set this down. If I go one, see she pushes this back at me and she comes up through the hole and hits. And it could be gua choi, do the gua choi. See, she could backhand. Sometimes she might rake overhead. That's more lao xing choi. So if the hand has a hard time getting through and you just kind of wipe down, that's lao xing choi. So let's do this in the flow. Okay, so one, she comes through. One, two, three, kick. Again. Last time. Okay, that's number two. All right, now when we move into number three, we're gonna say that I broke away. Almost like the first one. Remember the one, we went here and I broke away and I just signed the mitt. That's because she had a clear shot at the face. We're gonna say now there's an obstruction up. So when she goes one, my hand stays up. We broke away, so now she pocks out. Then she punches. One, two, three, and kick. So again, one, I break away, pocks out. One, two, three, kick. What they'll also say is pak da. Da is the punch. So one, pak da. One, two, three, kick. Last time. Split. Pak da. One, two, three, and kick. Okay, that's our number three. Let me swing it this way. I really want the camera to catch all the angles on this. First one. One. She just comes in. One, two, three, kick. Do it again, please. One. One, two, three, and kick. All right, the number two. One, she stays connected. One, two, three, and kick. One more time. See how she stays connected and she backhands or lao xing choi and then kick. The last one is I break away and then she catches up with it. One, two, three, kick. One more time, please. Break away. One, one, two, three, kick. Let me add one thing. I'm going to surprise Diana with this, but if she went split entry, and if I backed up too far, don't move yet, she might have to go BG now tech. Remember our entries? And then go into it. Either if there was nothing there, she would just hit it, or she could poxal or whatever. But the idea is if you feel too much of a gap, instead of just going, whoa, and trying to run in, you could fill the gap with the entry and then go back into it. We're not going to do that now. I just want you to know it. You're an advanced student now. You need to know this. All right, so again, number one, 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 two, three, kick. Number two, stays connected, and kick. Number three, I break away, my arms up. One, two, three, kick. Now, the number four, watch this. I go one, she goes to do almost like number two, but this time when she goes to do it, I force the hand back up. So now we've connected. You ever see Enter the Dragon? Everybody fights this way? Well, this is what they took it from. Nobody fights this way, except you're in the movie Enter the Dragon. But right now, this is what they call the connection, all right? Or we bridged, all right? So when we go here, one, she goes come around, I go connect. Then she pocks out, one, two, three, and kick. One more time. Let me spin you around for this last one. Okay, watch this. So she's gonna go one, connect, pock, one, two, three, kick. So she goes pock sal, I go up. All right, dead slow. Pock sal, and she goes to come over, but I keep the arm up, I get away from her. She clears the barrier and hits, and then goes into her punching series and kick. Again, slowly, right there, right here. One, two, three, kick. Now at speed, please. Okay, number one, split entry. One, two, three, kick. Number two, she stays connected. Number three, I break away. Pox out. One, two, three, kick. Number four, I meet. One, two, three, and kick. Okay, that's the four at the start. We got more to do, but this is what we call one response back, meaning, or a single trap back, because what we do is we go one, and then no matter which one, she does one single trap. One, two, three, four. Stay tuned, more to come. Okay, we're gonna go into a pox out BUG drill that I do. All this does is transition me from left side to right side. It's a really good drill because you're not going to be able to pick a favorite. Actually, it's actually better taught straight on. You could do it in Yichi Kim Young Ma if you want, or just be relaxed. All right, so if I go Pak Sal, I go B-U-G, Pak Sal. B-U-G, Pak Sal. This is it. You got the whole drill. So I'm just going to put that wedge in, trap, slap. Wedge in, slap. Wedge, slap. Okay? So as you feel more comfortable, pick up the pace. Okay, good. Okay, it's gonna tenderize the arm a little bit. You're gonna see your partner is gonna hate it. He's gonna, let's switch. I wanna do it to you for a while. But always remember, there's revenge. He gets his turn too. Not today, it's my video. So we're gonna go. Pak Sal. B-U-G, Pak Sal is the drill, okay? So this is the entire thing. It's simple. You'll see, it's gonna help your trapping a lot. Especially like if we line up and if I have to go here, it gets me there. But if we line up, some people, they have a hard time getting that. This drill will put it into you right away. All right, so now we're gonna go Lop Sal. He's gonna let me get away with it. See, he's not blocking. Then he's gonna go Pak Sal and he'll block. B-U-G, Lop, Pak. B-U-G, Lop, Pak. So that's all I want you to do. Just start slow. Get your partner to, it gets him to like understand what you're doing. He's not gonna panic and start to muscle it and lock the drill up. Then you're gonna see the drill's gonna you're gonna get flustered in it. It's not gonna go smooth. Just sit there and just go start off slow. Okay, let me slow it down. All right, I lop, I pock. I lop, I pock. The B-U-G goes in each time. The B-U-G puts me on the other side of his body. Okay, so with that, the third stage comes up, which is just Pak Sal, Lop Sal, Pak Sal. So we go Pak Sal, he lets me have it, see he's not blocking. Pak Sal, Lop Sal, Pak Sal, transition. Pak Sal, Lop Sal, Pak Sal, transition. Pak, Lop, Pak. B-U-G, Pak, Lop, Pak. Whenever I was saying transition, I meant the B-U-G. It just transfers me over to the opposite side of his body. Pak, Lop, Pak. 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 Pak, lop, pak, pak, lop, pak, pak, lop, pak. Okay, so remember, first one, when he blocks, just Pak Sal. Just go slow, this is nothing wrong. Even being experienced going this slow, you'll still learn. Second one, Lop Sal. Pak Sal, Lop Sal, Pak Sal, Lop Sal, Pak Sal. Third one, Pak Lop Pak, Pak Lop Pak, Pak Lop Pak, Pak Lop Pak, Pak Lop and Pak. Okay, so that's Pak Sal B-U-G drill. It's just good, it's gonna make you get good on both sides, left and right, and with the transition on how to get over. Okay, we're going into the grappling series now. Now, in Junfang Gung Fu, some of the influences that Bruce Lee had were Jean LaBelle, Wally J, and he did an art called China. So a lot of the judo came from Jean LaBelle, the jiu-jitsu came from Wally J, and then he had China instructors, and just who knows where else some of his influences came. If you ever look through the Dao Jikun Do, they have a whole photo-by-photo sequence of the grappling that he liked to do. So right now, we're gonna go through a little bit for you. So I'm gonna bring Joe in. Okay, Now, this is still a continuation on. If you've done the Joust House series, which you should have done already on this series, in the advanced series, when we come in, I can come in from the distance. I'm going to close the gap. One, two, this will hit in, and I'm going to go around. Now, the Helix series, which I also have, will go around from here. But we're going to say right now, I try to go split entry. One, I'm hitting right in here. If he's successful with the block, I split and I hit. Let me move him this way. All right, so watch this. One, two, I try to go split. Then I'm going to come around, and I'm just going to hook him. Okay? We're going to say he's wise to that. Joe defends himself. One, and he puts that hand up. I wasn't successful. I didn't get the hit. So I'm going to pull. First one, we say he resists back. He pulls back. So if I pull, he pulls back. All right? So one more time. One, two. I go in. I go around. I pull. He pulls back. Now I'm going to stick my shoulder right under his armpit. Okay? One more time. Very slow. I come in, one, two, hit, I go around. He blocked it, you see it? Normally, I want success, I want to hook him. But if he goes around, he blocks it, it didn't make it. Next thing, I pull. Remember, we can headbutt, we have a lot of other things that we could do. I already taught you in the Joust House series. But the first one is I pull down, maybe I wanted to headbutt, but he pulls back. So instead of me trying to keep playing a tug of war with him, I let it go. I place my shoulder right under the armpit, right here. So one more time. One, two, go in, go around. I pull, he pulls back, I come in. Important point, I don't want to do it this way, because if I just come in and I grab him, and if I'm not stuck under there, he's going to try to come out, and likely, I'm going to get clipped, okay? Even if he doesn't mean to clip me, I bet you if I'm just here holding him, he's going to try to swing out, and odds are, I'm going to catch some of that. I don't want to catch any of it. So what I do, one, two, go in, go around. I pull, he pulls back, I go in. I plaster my head right on his shoulder. Do you see it? I'm under his armpit with my shoulder, and then I put my head right here. Swing out, Joe. See it? Go swing up high and come out. See, it's kind of hard, okay? So that's where I want you to do it. I want you to come in and bear hug him. You bury your head right in there. So one, two, three, go around. I pull, he pulls back. I come in. Now this is going to bring me to the next part. I can grab here, or what I do is I hug tight and look at my hand. I transfer my elbow out, and then I put my hand kind of where the web of the thumb is right here, right against his leg. So one more time. One, two, in, go around. I pull, he pulls back. I come in. You see it? So now this, I am going to press. What I think about doing is I think about pressing his knee right into the mat. So I just go right here. Now look at what I did. I stayed with him. I buried my head right into the ground with him. All right. It didn't mean I hit my head to the ground. I just stay connected right here. Let me do that again from the other side. Swing you this way. Okay, so watch this. One, two, I go in, I go around, I pull. He pulls back, I come here. I bury it down, and I'm right here. Okay? Can you see how my shoulder is stuck right in his chest? Transfer it around again. One more time. One, two, I go in, I go around, I pull. He pulls back, I come in. Now I press it down. When he goes down, what I do is I hook this. I don't want this arm to get free. So I'm here, I hook it, and once I capture it, if I don't like the person, which I'm fighting him, who knows, right? I punch straight through to the ground. One more time. If I don't like him, I punch straight through. If it's a friendly sparring match, I might put my hand here, okay? Then all I do is I come around, and then I just arm bar him right like this. I know a lot of people are going to look. Let me swing you around this way, little Joe. A lot of people are going to look and go, oh, God. If you know anything about grappling, a lot of people feel that the one leg over, one leg back, they don't feel it's safe because the guy can escape. See, they can run out, okay? A lot of people do it. It's a good defense. What I like to do is I just kind of put this hand right here, run out. It stops it. Try it. If you're a grappler, and if you've never seen this, this might serve you well. If you get one foot over, just lift the head, and it's gonna like run out. So he starts to run, and I pick it up. Okay. So in Jin Fight, this isn't a friendly sparring match usually. When they're here, they just try to wrench it and go. So they don't care. Even if he's running, they just try to really jerk it, and they just want to hurt the arm. But if you're in this situation to where you want to hold the person, This is good. Get out. Go away. See? Kind of pins them here. Okay? So again, we go. BUG, now tech. One, around. I pull, he pulls back, I come in. I press him to the ground. You see it? I stay with him. I stay connected. No freedom. All right? I hook and I punch through or press through. I just hop up and then I armbar. I can hold the head if I feel he's going to run on me. Okay? That's our number one in the grappling series. Okay? I'm going to kind of do it at three quarter. I'm just trying to figure out the best position to show you. So start here. One, two, pull back. I step in. I press him down, punch through, step, turn, and then see it? I go right here. Okay? The number two in the series is virtually the same thing. So when I go one, two, I come in, I go around. When I pull, this time he doesn't pull back. Meaning, like the first one, when I pulled him down, he pulled back, and that's what made me come into the side. But let me swing you. All right, watch this. One, two, I come in, I go around. I pull, he stays there. So now I go to the opposite side. So now it's the same thing. All I'm doing is I'm just reversing everything that I did. If I come in one, I pulled. He didn't pull back, so now I go to the side. I don't try to pull him and throw his arms back because he's probably not going to be compliant the way Joe was with me right now. One, two, when I come in here and I go around, after I pull it, I step in. I hug. Again, my head's not out. I don't want to get clipped, right? My head bears in. My hand comes in same way, web of the hand on the back of the knee. I press it directly straight down, and then I just bear down into him. Do you see that? So I stayed with him for the whole ride. I hook the arm. Can you see my hand here? I don't know if you can get that. I press in. I just swing over and go into the arm bar. I can still hold the head. All right, let me show it again. Let me show it from this side. Back up. All right, one, two. I go in around. I pull, close in. Head's tight, arm hooks in, back of the hand, you see that? Okay, then I press down, bury him into the mat, stay with him for the whole ride, I hook. This will press down or I can hit down. I come over, right here, arm bar. If I wanna hold the head, I hold the head. Okay, that's the number two in our series. All right, virtually the same, you just need to know, if I pull and he pulls back, I go to his left. If I pull and he doesn't pull back, I come into his right. Make sure your head's buried in, key part. Press in, okay? So whichever armpit you get to, just remember that the outside hand presses in. You got that? Okay, so now it's gonna go to our number three. The number three is gonna go one, two, in, same way here. This time, watch this. I pull the hand, I hit the shoulder. Let me swing him this way. All right. One more time. One, I go in one round. So I pull and I hit the shoulder. Do you see that? So as soon as the hand's up, I went split entry, swing around with the jiao sao. I pull this hand, I pop this shoulder. Later, it could be pop the face, but right now, even in a fight, it still could be pop the shoulder, okay? One more time. One, two, in, around. Pull, pop the shoulder. This is gonna turn right here. All I'm gonna do is underhook. And then this takes him down. Then I'm just gonna step over, and again, single leg armbar, okay? He comes in, one more time. One, two, I go in, I go around. Pull and hit it. Hook the neck, or you could hook under. It doesn't matter. Whatever the direction is, single leg, it's just a reap. You're reaping, then you step over, sit back, single leg armbar, okay? Come on back up. The whole idea, if I don't get that hit back on the shoulder, so if I go one, two, in, and I just pull, and if I step, he's gonna step back. Good, okay, one more time. So one, two, in, cycle right here. It grounds him a little bit. You'll see, if he does step back, I can go into other things. Let me get into that in a second. But right now, if he bears in, and usually he will, if I go like that, he's gonna bear into it. Okay, so one more time, one, two, in, I go right here. Now all I do is come right here. So watch my feet. I go one, two. See it? Right like that. Like we're dancing, okay? So when we go here, one, two, go in, I pull and I hit it. So I go right here. So once I'm here, I just reap it, step over, arm bar. Okay, you got that? All right. That was our number three. Now watch this. Number four, again, virtually the same. One, two, in, around, pull, hit it. Now I go to reap. And if you've been training this, you're gonna try this and you're gonna see it happen sometimes. Sometimes I go to reap and he doesn't go down. So when I reap, the leg comes up. Just don't, I don't wanna hurt you, just go with it a little bit. So it goes up, but he doesn't fall, okay? So one more time. One, two, in, I go around, I hit it. Now I go here, I go whoop, oh, he didn't go down, step here. You see it? So I just step over to the second leg. And then again, arm bar. Move you back a little bit. So one, in, I go here. This just goes right here. I know I'm moving fast. I'll do it slow for you. So one, I reap, I step. See where he's at? Step over, arm bar. Okay, come on this side, Joe. Real slow. One, two, in, around, pull and push. Step, step, kick. Oh, that leg came up. He didn't go down. I just step over. Step right over the head and arm bar. Okay, that's the number four in the system. Okay, so now continuing on with that entry, one, two, pull, hit. Next one is I want you to drop your forearm right to the thigh. Okay, so watch this. One, two, in and around. I hit it and then I just go right here. So this is gonna put him down. One more time. One, two, split, go around. I pull, I push that, then this drops. Right from here, I just go right like that. I press it down. Now, in Jun Feng Kung Fu, they'll snake the leg like this, secure it in. I wanna get the toe a little bit bent. I don't want it, bend your foot. This is no good. I wanna get on it, you see it? So what they do, and I'm not gonna do this for real. In training, I step on the leg. Combat, we step on the groin, okay? You don't need to do that, okay? So. Not in your training anyway. So one, two, split, go around, pull and hit, drop, press it down. Come up, you're gonna pick it up. Right now I'm not even stepping on it. Normally I would step on it, okay? Or step on it. Okay, so let's try that one more time. Okay, one, two, split entry, go around, hit it, drop, press him to the ground. You go right into it. I'm not stepping on it. In training, I could go here. But it is good to get the habit of stepping. Like I said, you don't need to step on the groin right now. Okay, that's our number five. Now, obviously, let me show you one, two. If I go one way, I can go the other way. But that means I have to step. Let me swing it this way. It'll make more sense. If I go one, two, around, pull, punch that shoulder away, I step. Do you see it? So right here, when I'm in this position, I just pop the shoulder, I step. See, this will press it. Now, the only difference is I go outside it. Again, I would step on the groin. Let's not do that right now, okay? I'm sure Joey will appreciate that. So, Byuji, Now Tech, split entry, Jiao Sao, pull, hit the shoulder, step, and right now, my forearm hits the inner thigh, and I press it down. Now, I grab it, this would step, and pull up into the lock. Make sure that you arch, it gets that toe bent, okay? All right, so that's the number six in the system. All right, so now we're gonna leave the Jiao Sao and we're gonna go to a jab cross. First one, the number seven is he jabs, he crosses. I wanna pock, lop. Again, come on this side. All right, one, two, three. So one more time. One, two, three. Sorry about that, Joe. All right. I wrap, this is the figure four. See how it looks like a number four right here? They call it a figure four position. So again, parry, pock, lop. Wrap it, this drops right here. See, this is what we call a gooseneck lock. I just compress it here. If I don't like him, I put a knee in and I just lift up on the arm, lift it, and then press the wrist in. And when I compact it, it'll put all the pain on. All right, one more time. Okay, so I parry. Pock, lop, all right? So as he goes, one, two, three, then I wrap it. I drop it, all right? I can put the knee all the way over the face too if I care to. Do you see that? So right now, if I didn't like him, my knee would drop right on the face, and then we go into what we still call that gooseneck lock, okay? I just hold it right here, This was my figure four, see the four still? And now I just put the forearm through it and lift, okay? So whatever we do on one side, we could repeat on the other side. So he goes, one, two. When he blocks it, I lop, see it? So one, pak sao, lop sao. Figure four the opposite way, okay? And now I just put the knee down, or I could put it all the way over the face, just like I had said before. Okay, get up again, please, this side. So, pak sao, lop sao, figure four. Drop your weight, you see it? Put that over, and gooseneck lock. So, can you see how I leave this arm in? I lift up on it. The combination of me lifting up and the compression up puts it on him, okay? All right, so that's what number eight that should be. So right now, when you go one, two, three, I didn't show this before, but one other thing that you could put in is the elbow. So one more time, all right. One, two, I can elbow it as I take the figure four. The same thing here. One, two, when he stops it, I can elbow it to help motivate him to go down for me. Okay, so with that, we're gonna go into the next one. The next one is he's gonna go one, two. When he stops it, I will go loy pak sao. You guys should know that by now. So peri, pak, loy pak. This can elbow the bicep, then I just pull. Look at my hands. They just kind of weave if we're on his right arm, my left arm weaves inside, my other arm's gonna go right up on the back of the tricep. So one more time. One, pak, loy pak. I kiss that off there, and then I go right here. See, this will just pull him straight down. Now, if you look, let me kind of slide you this way. So right here, it's a bent arm lock with the gooseneck from the face down position. Okay, so I just go right here, and then this helps it. Okay, so one more time, this side. So when he goes here, I go pak, loy pak sao, elbow. Then right here, I just drop it straight down. See where I'm at? I just put this on right here, okay? So right now, if I get him down, my left arm is weaving his right arm, and then I just bend this and put some pressure on it, okay? All right, with that, there are times when he goes one, two, and I slap it off, I elbow. So I pull him, and I go to take him to the ground, but he catches himself. He doesn't let me get him to the ground. So watch what I do. I step over, and then I'm just gonna lay down over here, and then I put the arm bar on the opposite side of the body, okay? Let's go from this side. So he goes one, I go one, two, elbow. I pull it. So right here, I just step, and then I lay down. This puts it on the opposite side of the body, okay? So I put the arm bar on. All right, so when he goes, peri, pak sao, pak on the inside, I elbow it. This pulls him, I step down. When I step down, I didn't mean to do that hard to you, but it really puts him low, enough to where I could turn my body and sit back, and it rolls him right into the arm bar, okay? All right, now you're in the advanced series chi sao section, okay? So now I left you off at number 9. We're gonna come into number 10. I'm gonna bring Joe in. All right, so from your roll, you already have a lot of techniques going on. We're gonna add to it. Now, if you remember in the Ung Moon drill, I showed you this motion, okay? So this is go lan sao da. We're gonna add it right into our chi sao. So if you watch, what I do is I come up, see my elbow kind of covers his arm, the trap, and I'm gonna sut sao, drop, and then punch. Let me swing you over this way. All right, so when we're rolling, I go one, two, three, four. So out of the flow, it's gonna look something like this. Very slow. I come up, trap, sut sao, sut sao. This hand will drop and cover. And then I punch. Okay, very slow again. Okay, that was Golan Sauda. Now, we're gonna go into the next one. The next one is gonna be putting the Dan Chi back in. Remember Dan Chi? One, two, three, one, two, three. But I'm gonna kinda add a little bit more to it for you. So, do you remember when I had you go Dan Chi and then I came back and I went to attack again? Well, it's gonna look like that, except this time, when he goes, he's gonna Bong Sao, like he got up going there. Let's do it one more time, okay? One, he puts the Bong Sao up. So I'm in Tan Da, which you've learned already from the Ung Moon drill, and then I'm gonna trap this arm, and I'm gonna punch. Let's do that again. Okay, one more time. One, two, and I punch. Notice how my one more time is about 10 more times, but that's okay. All right, so we're gonna keep going. One, two, Pak Sao. But Joe's not gonna let me get away with that now. So what he's gonna do is one, two, when I punch, he stops it, okay? Then he's gonna inside whip. Remember the Lao Sing Choi, also from that Ung Moon cycle that I've shown you, or Ung Moon drill, sorry. Okay, so one, two, Pak, Lao Sing Choi, and this will hit, okay? But I'm not gonna let him get away with that either, right? So one, two, and then I meet forearms. Pak Sao, Lop Sao, now we're into the Lop Sao cycle. Now Joe puts his back in the Chi Sao by placing his arm there. It's cooperative. He tells me, all right, let's play again. All right, so one, two, Pak Sao. Okay, let's slow it down so I could explain it. All right, so we go Dim Jern or Jik Jern. Now when he punches, I Tan Da, which forces him to Bong Sao. So I trap the arm off, I shoot my hand in. He stops me right there, he parries. They call it one pak. This hand will shoot up and through. That's Lao Sing Choi. I know it's a lot, don't worry about it. You're gonna get this. Our arms will meet Pak Sao, Lop Sao, and then just go a few cycles in this. It just kinda, it's good to burn this into you. This is, you know, they redo motions a lot, and the reason why it's so repetitive is because you need it. So just burn that motion into you. So. Just go into the Lop Sao cycle, give it 5 to 10 reps, and then go back into your Chi Sao. So one more time, one, two, trap. He stops it, he whips in. Lao Sing Choi is what, like they say, inside whip, okay? So one more time. One, two, Pak Sao, he parries inside, I meet it. I trap it and punch, he parries, I Lop Sao, or I pull, and now we're just gonna go Lop Sao a few times. And when he's good and tired of it, he is gonna place me back in. Or, I don't wanna confuse you, but I want you to know the options. If we go through the whole cycle again and we're into Lop Sao, I can put my hand there and now we're on the other side, okay? So one, two, trap, he comes through, Pak Sao, Lop Sao. Always try to remember to have that thumb here, don't get that full grip going. And we go back into Chi Sao. Okay, so you can do it left side or right side. Okay, one more time, real slow. One, two, trap. I punch, he blocks, he inside whips. I meet it right here. Trap it, pull it, then we just go into the Lop Sao cycle. And when he's tired of it, he returns back to the Chi Sao. Okay, now I wanna go on to number 12. All right, and number 12, we're gonna go to Jiao Sao. So remember, Jiao Sao is running hand, okay? If we're rolling, I act like I want his face. See it? I draw him in because I want to get the hit here or the slap. We went over all this, okay? So my option here is to go right here. So he catches it, he's gonna come back at me. Okay, one last time, real slow. When I go one, he comes, he twists into Tan Sao, then he's gonna come back with the Jik Jern. I pull it with the Jut. He goes into Bong Sao, then he rolls back to Tan as if it's over, but this is called Hun. I whip around on the inside, then he's gonna Jut, punch, and that's a rep. Okay, real slow. One, he catches it, comes back at me, I pull it. Goes to Bong Sao. I loop as he comes back around. I attack one last time, he punches, that's a rep. Let me get rid of this hand for a second. So if we do this with one hand, it goes one, catch, come back at me, Bong Sao. As he goes to go back in a Tan, I whip around it. See that? I drop my hand at him and he punches. So in flow, goes one, two, three, roll around, and we're back into the roll. Right now, this is just cooperative. This hand's just gonna stay stationary, but we're there, but we're still aware of each other. It's not just like I forgot about my hand and I'm doing this whole thing. I'm aware of what he's doing with this, and he's aware of me. We should, like I said, your spider senses should be going, okay? You gotta have that turned on, okay? So one more time. One, two, three, roll around, and back in. Okay, last time. There it is. Okay, so right there, that's our number 12. Remember the number 11 that we did. Okay, if I went one, okay, we're gonna combine the number 12 and the number 11. So again, I'm gonna do the number 11 for you. You already did it. Okay, all right, so when we do the number 11, it went from doing Dan Chi and then into this drill that I've already taught you. Now the number 12 went around, and now we went back to the number 11. Did you see it? So I just combined it, okay? So the number 12 goes around. Now when I come around, Instead of us, let me do just the number 12 by itself. Instead of us just going one, back around, down, and then back into just the basic Luxal roll, we add the other second half of the number 11. So it's kind of going number 12, then dropping back into number 11. Let me do this slowly. Starts off just like number 12. There you go. So when I come around, one, here's where it changes. I go Tan Da. Pak Sao, Lao Sing Choi, Pak Sao, Lop Sao. About four or five times in the Lop Sao cycle, and then drop back into your roll. Again, slowly. One, comes out. Two, bong. Rolls back, comes down. That's the number 12. The number 11 went one, two, right here. The number 13 is a combination of both. Starts off 12, and it goes back to the number 11 flow. You see that? Okay, so now that's our number 13 that we're on. Okay, so now we're gonna take it a little bit further. Rolling, remember the Pak Sao sectors where I went out here and I went Pak Sao? All right, here's fake time. So watch this. I'm still gonna do the Jiao Sao, but I wanna go to Noi Tan Sao. So now we're working on number 14. So from the roll, I come out and I Jiao Sao. See it? He caught me. He comes down, Bong Sao, rolls back. It's okay. There, and there we go. So one more time. I come out, around. One, two, he rolls back, down, and we're back into the roll. See it? I want you to do this shift, because it looks like I'm gonna go right here, okay? In fact, I'm hoping that Joe will get faked and go there, because if he does, I can get this, okay? So we go one, there, he caught me. Now we go back into that number 12 roll, okay? Last time, real slow. One, Pak Jiao, comes back Dim Jern, Bong Sao, I swing around again with the Hun Sao, and we just roll, okay? So that was our next one that we went to, number 14. All right, now I'm gonna go to 15. Here it comes. Same thing, one, two, three, four, back around, and you're probably guessing it, yes, it's just like the number 12. Trap goes inside, pop, or I should say like our number 11. Okay? I know I'm probably confusing you with all these numbers. Just review the take one at a time, and you'll get this. All right, so let me do this again. Noi Tan Sao, I'm gonna explain each one. Pak Jiao, Dim Jern, and I use the Jut Sao as a defense. Bong Sao, when I do the Chung Choi. He rolls in a Tan, I slip around it, Hoon. He does the Jut as I come in with the Jik Jern. He does Chung Choi, I do Bong Sao, okay? And then we roll, all right? So the next one after that went Tan. Jiao, Jut, Bong, Tan, Hun, Jut, Tan Da, Pak Sao, Lao Sing Choi, Pak Sao, Lop Sao. Then just roll a few times, get comfortable, kind of get your brain back together. So now I'm gonna recap everything for you, okay? So now we started off with number 10. I went Go Lan Sao, all right? One, two, three. Okay, the next one went Dan Qi, Pak Sao, Lao Sing Choi, Pak Sao to Lop Sao. Okay, got that? Okay, the next one, number 12, when we go into it, was Jiao Sao. So I go here, two, three, he rolls around, and we just go back to our roll. Okay, the next one, one, same way. When he rolls back and I come in, Tan Da, Pak Sao, and then back into our roll. Okay, the next one went outside. I trap and go around. Joe comes at me, bong, swing around, and we went back into the roll. The last one, outside, loop around, he comes at me, bong sao, I come around. This time I don't go back into roll when he punches, I tan da. Pak sao, lao sing choi, lop sao da. Okay, train those, we'll be back with more. Okay, you're in the advanced sets now. We had to do number 7. So we're gonna start off. This is gonna go 3 times. Gang jam, 2, 3. Right from there, I want you to step off. You're gonna go Wampak Biuji. Okay, one more time. 1, 2, 3. Wampak Biuji. Now I want you to go Sat Sao, Pak Sao Wan Jern. Let me do that again for you. 1, 2, 3. Wampak Biuji, Sat Sao, Pak Wan Jern. Bong Sao. Wampak Biuji, Sat Sao, Pak Wan Jern. Let's start that again. Real slow. 1, 2, 3. Wampak Biuji, Sat, Pak Wan Jern, Bong. Wampak Biuji, Sat, Pak Wan Jern. All right, now let me explain this. When we go, you're gonna start with the left, your left hand high. 1, 2, 3. Step off, important, get some room. You're gonna go 1, 2, 3. Otherwise, if I try to do it here, I'll never make it, I feel real jammed up. It doesn't feel too good, so make some room. 1, 2, 3, step off. 1, 2, 3. Bong Sao, step off. 1, 2, 3. Bong Sao again. Now this is gonna look weird. Watch my feet. This is a hardest part, is you gotta step over and around the leg. Because of the immobility of the dummy leg, you gotta kinda give way and step around it. You gotta remember, this is my training partner when there's nobody else around. So, you know, we do the best we can with it. It's not perfect, but it sure beats having nothing. So, we're gonna go. 1, 2, 3. Step off. 1, 2, 3. Bong Sao, come to the other side. 1, 2, 3. Bong Sao. Make that big step, come over. You're gonna go Tan Da, Ha Wan Jern, and then you're gonna kick the dummy leg right here. Okay? Then you're gonna step through, and then you gotta come over, and you're gonna kick the leg on the opposite body right here. That's pretty much it. You step down. It's a little like twisted and tied up, but again, it's because of the immobility of the dummy. Then you come center. They call this Jing Ma, the stance. So it's straight stance, like, or Jik Ma, they'll say. Okay, so then you come over. You're gonna palm the face, come around, just like you have been doing on the previous sets, like on set number 1 and set number 5. Okay, let's do this again. 1, 2, 3, step off. 1, 2, 3, Bong Sao, step off. 1, 2, 3, Bong Sao. You gotta do that cross step, kick the dummy. When you palm the dummy and you tanda. Bong sao, step off. Kick the dummy and palm it also. Step down, cross step, center yourself. Gong sao, hoon sao, jut da jik jern. Jiao sao, biuji, jut, tak sao. Let me do this one more time. I'm just gonna do it slow without any terminology. All right. Little faster. One more time. Okay, that's set number 7. Okay, we're on number 8 now. Let's get going right away. I want you to pak sao the inside of the arm right here, but you're gonna stomp kick the leg. So you're gonna go pak sao, dum tek. Okay, so you remember the cow sao? Cow sao will throw it. Okay, with the cow, you get the cow sao, what I want you to do is I want you to side kick. So when you apply this, this is gonna be pak sao, I stomp kick the knee, then I am gonna cup it, and then I am gonna kick the leg. Okay, one more time. One, two. Let's look at that on Larry. So it goes one, and then the cow sao hooks the arm, stomps the back of the knee. So watch this. I go one, two, right there. That's the start of number 8. Okay, so now you see the application. So let's get going with this. One, two. Step off. One, two. Now I'm going to come back in. This is gum sao. It means pressing hand. I want you to step off, step in, and palm the body. Okay, step out, palm, gum sao, step off, step in, and then you're going to palm the body. All right, let's do that again. All right, so it starts off. Pak sao dum tek, kao sao juk tek. Pak sao dum tek, kao sao juk tek. Gum sao, pak sao ha wan jern. Gum sao, pak sao ha wan jern. Then it goes gong sao, hoon sao, jut da jik jern, jiao sao to biuji, jut sao, tak sao. The end is again, just like number 1's ending. Let's do it again, real slow for you this time. One, pak stomp. Two, cup it, I mean not cup it, well, not cup sao, but cup the arm, or like you're lifting the arm, and stomp the leg. Pak, stomp, cup it, and kick the leg. Gum sao. Step over, pak, palm the body. Gum sao. Pak, ha wan jern to the body. Gong sao, hoon sao, jut da jik jern, jiao sao, biuji, jut sao, tak sao. So I'm gonna do this a little bit at speed for you. Again. Okay, I'm just gonna go now. Last time, here it goes. That's it, that's number 8. Okay, we're in a number 9 now. Getting close to the end. Here we go. You're gonna go ha bong sao. I want you to do this 3 times. 2, 3. Now my hand is always up at wu sao when I do this. So one more time. 1, 2, 3. Now I want you to kind of whip that up and then you're gonna turn and palm the face. Let's do that again. Low left, low right, low left. Left swings up to tan, turn and palm. Low right, up, palm. Tan sao. Let me show you that again. One, two, three, up, palm. One, up, palm. Tan. Now I want you to double grab the arm and you're gonna kick. Do you see that? Okay, let's do it again. One, two, three, up, palm. One, up, palm, tan. Kick, tan, double grab, kick. Gong, hoon, jut da jik jern, jiao sao, biuji, jut sao, tak sao. Okay, let's do it again. I'm gonna go slow this time through the whole thing. Okay, one, two, three. Swing up, palm the face. One, swing up, palm the face. Tan, double grab. See, I never lose it. After I do the tan, I just grab and I just sweep and kick. It's like I'm pulling him in and kicking the body, okay? Tan through, kick. Double hands, it's gong jam. Hoon, jut da jik jern, jiao sao, biu ji, jut sao, tak sao. Okay, I'm just gonna do it slow for you. Okay, it's not too hard. Let me do that again. Now I'm gonna go a little faster. Again. One last time. Slow. And that's number nine. Okay, now you finished it. The advanced levels. You tied it all together now. You got it. You are just about there. All right, now all we need to do is get back in there and we're going to get this apprentice level down. So what I wanted to stress within this advanced level is combining everything together. You got your kickboxing, you got your trapping. You need to get that all together. All right, so let's get this now, get it together now, and let's move it right into the apprentice level.